That I'm just fooling. Gap. I don't understand how rolling across gaps works.
Proper story is supposed to start at the beginning. Ain't so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world got all twisted, leaving him stranded on a rock in the sky. He gets up, sets off for the Bastion, where everyone agreed to go in case of trouble. Ground forms up under his feet as it pointing the way. He don't stop to wonder why. Finds his lifelong friend just lying in the road. Well, it's a touching reunion. He sees what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. In the calamity. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a gas fella. Forced out from underground. Sometimes you just need a drink. Got a holder still to spin up the chamber. A school of squirts tunnels up around him. Must have fled here from the mines.
Boy, that was cool.
He sets foot inside one of Celandia's famous watering holes. Inside's old Rondi, the bartender. The calamity got him for his drinking did. Then Kid finds his trusty shield. The security takes him for a petty thief.
Yeah.
Special delivery. Gas fellas. Windbags start turning up for last call.
That was terrible.
More squirts start coming out of the woodwork. A big old fella pops out in front of the kid.
Oh my god, how do I do that faster, please?
He gets a good look at things on his way down.
I wonder what I'm landing on top of.
He lands on top of a breaker's bow, and it ain't broke.
Oh.
Good news is the emergency defenses still work. Bad news is they're aiming for the kid. Right back at ya, he finds the distillery, right next to the arsenal. Tough part of town. The arsenal's where the kid can pick the best tools for the job. Some of them squirts berthing like crazy in a couple of corn bins. An old ferry barge sends the kid on his way. The Bastion's real close now.
Ah, slow.
Kid takes a chunk of alloy. Smell of barley and spoiled blueberries fills the air. Scumbags. Kid maybe shouldn't have done what he just did.
Eh?
He finds the core to the wharf district. Well, down he goes.
Alright, decent.
Down toward the Bastion. Now the kid sees something stranger still. His mind races. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds another. He finds me.
Dude, there's sick rolls.
And just like that, the Bastion comes alive. Starts growing and growing stronger. Kids gotta put its power to good use.
Okay, I could buy that happening.
Send him even farther into the wild unknown. Kid does it again. Only fair he decides what we build next. Kid don't know what's out there waiting for him.
Alright, flying at 347's alright. Not perfect, but alright.
In better days, the melting pot was sealed tighter than the skin on a squirt. Of all the plants to survive the calamity, it had to be stab weeds. Core stuck inside one of those fancy cages. Now what could possibly go wrong? Some of the stuff lying around.
Oh, that's a bad. That's double mine. Double bad mine placement, basically.
The cage starts lifting from the core ever so slow. All Kid can do is wait. Shipments start falling in.
Dumb.
every squirt's born bad, some spring to the kid's defense. Judging by the movement of the cage, it's gonna take a little while.
Take a wild guess that I've lost some time here by virtue of killing some of these slowly.
Scumbags don't take kindly to interlopers. Even some gas fellas take his corner. Heard he popped that mean old foreman. At this rate, maybe 5 more minutes. Maybe 30. Hard to tell.
That's interesting.
Real territorial around the core. Then a ship in a
give
free
me
sample shows
atomic.
Up. It ain't all bad. As the kid finds some spices from the motherland, tax free.
Might have derped a couple of those. Hard to say.
One thing's for sure, that cage is awful heavy.
Incidentally, it does not matter how quickly you kill those particular guys in this level. However, I think I just saved a boatload of time, possibly.
It's a troublesome scene to be sure. Moments left, and the core goes free. 10, 9, 8, 7. You give or take a few seconds. Finally, the core's within reach. And done. He's got it. Just gotta get to the nearest barge.
Dude, why do I hit that split so early? Whatever. I saved 4.5 seconds.
I still remember the look on his face after that one.
Oh, I might have rolled too far. Finished, please don't tell me I rolled too far. Crap.
The cores. They remember. That's why this place is coming together. That's why things are gonna be alright. Kid ponders what to build. We tracked down a couple more cores near the edge of the city.
Alright, so I lost like 0.5 seconds because I hit the split too early, and another 0.5 or so in the Bastion on that extra roll.
Ought to be a core down one of these twisted streets. But which one? And there it is. But it's locked down tight in an alley cage, almost like he's showboating for the crowd. He hears the whole place groan, but it's too tough to fall.
Wow, so I actually saved 0.5 seconds or so here.
He comes back, just like I knew he would. The core hums in his pack. The monument's calling for it. Zorf's travels ain't much compared to what the kids had to go through for all this. Kid's surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either.
Alright, Hang Gardens, where I can still save 4 freaking seconds if I do this right. For the love of God, do it right.
The dead.
Don't be an idiot.
The calamity took everybody after all. Kid sees it plain, frozen faces all around. These folks never saw the calamity coming, but someone did. Someone close. It was someone like him. It's a snag or two trying to get to him. He ain't about to stop, no matter what. He's got so many questions after all.
Alright, that wastes a small bit of time.
Nor did the bird boy. Didn't make it. But him, he survived.
What? Fine, whatever. Man, whatever, it's fine.
We wouldn't be here right now, would we? What do you say to a man who's seen too much? Kid hasn't a clue.
Alright, fine. Good enough.
You have to go. Please.
Now I have to not even fail the Cinderbrick Fort gate at the end one time. Not even one time.
No hiding, he's an Ura. Folks like him ain't never been a common sight in Ceylandia. He's relieved to see a living face or two. The kid and I introduce ourselves in kind. Both to him and to each other for the first time.
Come on.
Zulf banged up the monument pretty bad. But there's a way to put it back together. The shards.
Two.
That's
all right.
It. A few more shards like that, and we'll be back in business. A single shard can breathe new life into this place. The shard's got enough juice to spruce up any of these places. The city tried to use the shards to stake out the wilds. So much for that plan.
All right, come on.
There's only one way into Cinderbrick Fort.
The hard way.
The hard way. Sure, the city marshals may be gone, but now the fort's crawling with windbags. The calamity was mercy, normal folks. At least the marshals left the kid a parting gift. Something the windbags just can't handle. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy hides. Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Not a scratch on him as he presses on the higher ground. Times like this, kids glad he packed trip mines. Security's plain gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. They trapped the kid in the middle of the fort's parade grounds. The skyway's a welcome sight after all that. And now I
know. Oh man, alright.
Cinderbrick Fort.
I did one time less, like, I can't get that to happen again, so I've decided that it's not.
Shows up just as Zulf's telling me
it's not a thing that you can do consistently.
All that trouble for a single shard. But you know what? It was worth it.
Alright. If I have a good Rothus and I have a good Colford, I'm gonna world record here. That's not how you do it. Alright, that's about half a second wasted. Okay, Rothus.
Ain't gonna build itself.
Okay, that's about a second wasted.
Ankle
minus 8.9 or so now.
And they nested at Rothus Lagoon.
I just need the damn skips to go properly. That was dumb. And that just screwed me.
All kinds of beasts were
3 seconds blown.
Still looking about. They used to think that ankle gators were extinct. Well, they ain't. Turns out Queen Anne got a hold of a shard. Ankle gators love shiny things. The brushers use their pikes to keep their distance around here. Now the kid can do the same. Queenie leads the kid into some kind of twisted trap. The closer you get to an ankle gator's lair, the thicker the tall grass grows. One bad step in that.
Come on.
It's Queen Anne's lunch. Wanna know how to find an ankle gator lair? You use a kid as bait. Now she's coming for him. She's got nowhere else to go. The shard sitting in plain view after all.
All right, 2 seconds lost. It's all right.
Hope Queen Anne don't mind us borrowing from her treasury.
Crap.
The shard works like a charm. You can hear the monument's heartbeat again.
All right, Colford Cauldron has to go really well. Or this
the
is going to be bad.
Zulf sure did a number on it, though. The arsenal's complete, in case we need protection. High time we built something.
Alright, here goes, guys. Get hype. More importantly, get hoop.
Not everything blew up in the calamity. Why, Colford Cauldron here blew up way ahead of its time. The cauldron boiled over.
Oh, I got, I had it, I was close, I have it now.
With ash and the lakes with molten rock.
Then I fell, that's bad. Really bad.
We learned an Sure, we dusted off a good many secrets out here, but we discovered other things.
I went super conservative just there, just now.
All sorts of awful things crawling underfoot. Places inhospitable as they come. After all, when we look down inside Colford Cauldron, look down through all the smoke and flames, we had to have it. As for the kid,
get away from me, bird.
He just has to get that shard out of there. Too bad taking that thing woke up every last
stink
eye from here to Jocelyn Bog. And where there's one stink eye, there's always more.
What? How did I even fall there? There's nothing there to fall off of.
The cauldron's tenants all gather up.
We got it. We got it. All right, it doesn't matter. We fucking got it. Come on, don't botch it. Don't botch it. Don't botch it. Just finish it off.
The shards can put this disease in remission. One cure. We need to finish what we started. The Bastion. It's finally finished. Now, there's something I want you to see. Welcome to the heart of the Bastion. I ain't one for long.
Alright, come on.
So here's the deal. Zia and I figure you've done the heavy lifting, so you get to do the honors. We can tell you how to work this thing if you got any questions. Hey, kid.
New PB! Yes!
It's finished. Now, sit down.
Frickin' awesome.
It'll be over soon.
Colford Cauldron sucked so bad. Oh my god. I can't believe I fell twice.
No matter what happens now,
I took so long to get that skip.
Good.
But I got a new PB.
All that's left.
I have so much further to go. Oh my god, dude.
The Bastion's gonna take us back to a better time. Before any of this. Might be we'll forget everything you've done. And each other. Though after all we've been through, I find that hard to believe. So long, kid. Maybe I'll see you in the next one. Ceylandia.
Oh.
We're coming home.
I can still save time in Hanging Gardens. Oh my god, Hanging Gardens, why are you so dumb? And I can save time in Cinderbrick Fort. Phew. That really should have been like a 16-19 or something, but whatever. I think I'll do another glare run now. After the credits.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, Lysik, no question. The rolls alone are a huge deal. Anytime you're not rolling, you're running. And anytime you're running, you're losing time. So, don't run. You should, man. You should pick up all these awesome indie PC games. They're all really good. Oh, that's true. Transistor is coming out very soon. Just a couple months. Yeah, Lysik, the game you're thinking of is called Ni No Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. And that game is very beautiful and very long, is what I'm told.